taken by Vilyege Zulu. Starts out on the right-hand flank. Iwuti, lovely pass through to Ryland Peterson. Zirali, though, is another one of the significant injury concerns. He's injured his right foot and is out potentially for some time as well. That said, a minute in, Tekumurise. I am not going to throw you in.
You know, playing against AmaZulu, where they were in the lead of 2-0, where they could have easily won the game, they struggled to manage the game. I think they come into this game knowing that if they find themselves in that type of a situation again, they need to manage the game very better. And with Maritzburg, I think it's a team that...
Orlando Pirates, subsequently signed from Orlando Pirates by Chipper United. Richie. Uses a right back. His cousin Robin Johannes, part of a successful Stellenbosch victory. He's part of this weekend's results. Saw them go second, but Royal AM have now leapfrogged them. Level off the Chiefs earlier. As Richie and Evang are battling one another. He gets a touch on it. Richie flicks it up, flips the chest, and all out for the throw into Maritzburg United, taken quickly. Richie to take this one. He'll curl it away from the goalkeeper, Charlie. The Sukuna has been relieved, but he's the man who has it here. Second Zulu are doing some serious clearing.
To get your full compliment of...
This ball comes in again. It's Zulu who's got his head on. Hottest bone in the body, and I'm still wondering how it even broke. Klaassen has possession for Uti. Going back to Richie here. Then they've got the long-term injuries of Ramakalela and Pagamani Mahlambi among them, and Lodi Ngele. So 10 minutes has come and gone. Goalless it is, but in terms of entertainment and position on the pitch, there's been plenty of end-to-end stuff happening. Fairley getting a touch. Maritzburg United won it back in Kiwuti again with a delightful pass. He's chosen to make his way back to South Africa after a relatively successful career in Europe. Maritzburg United very deliberately maintaining possession opportunities from a few teams in the DStv Premiership. His delivery, though, steered away.
That in terms of goalkeepers knowing how to distribute very well.
Yeah, Reina Dinkelaka, of course, was the expert on it. That's it. Libizzo here going for a little ball into a heart and mouth moments for Maritzburg United. And that free kick, he has the responsibility of the corner. Worked toward the back post, and it looked to be a decent header set up.
The 16-yard area, that's a goalkeeper's area where he needs to come out and command.
Peterson takes it out wide. There's Nenga on it. Received from Genasi, releases for Richie. Hoping to pick out Song on him. He's up against the tall man, Mklinzo, but on this occasion has failed to go the direction of the man waiting up front. Richie, meanwhile, has gone down the line beautifully, but Sukuna unable to control it as he would like. There's Graham. Possession stats, they go relatively even in the early stages of this tie, with Orlando Pirates hosting Marumo Gallants and Mamelodi Sundowns visiting AmaZulu. Battle of 1 and 2 from last season. Richie here. Ngane getting a struggle to score goals in the early stages of the season, scoring only 3 goals in their first 10 matches. They've scored in each of their last 5 matches under Kurt Lenke. Already scored 5 of the 6 goals in the time that Lenke's has been in charge. But yes, set pieces is to be an area that they should exploit or be able to use.
See that, you know, Theron on the other side, tightly marking him, you know, putting him out of the game.
Richie nods this away. Yes, you're right. Maybe it's the red cards, coaches sent to the stands. They don't go to the change room, they get sent to the stands. That's the only difference. The dismissals of the game, but yes, yellow cards do.
For the person who's on the ball, he has to cross. So I think Sungwane needs to learn to get into those areas very quickly as soon as possible, because those are goal scoring opportunities. That's where he's going to score goals.
To calm matters by steering it back to his goalkeeper, and immediately, with his palms pointed to the ground, pumps the arm suggest let's slow it down a little. Maybe every so often you need that reminder. It's good look. Cosmos Black Leopards, also part of the Maritzburg United squad. Far from being the only team who have players who share surnames. Richie looks to feed in. It's helped on its way, out of play on the far. Well, when you feel it, you feel it. Now, this has just happened. We're seeing that replay, a collision. Plenty of experience as Dalen Klaassen to Maritzburg United side that is relatively inexperienced in certain areas. And Middendorp has not been afraid to bring in some youngsters, and certainly the bench today is
opportunities. If I remember, so there was a a tap in that Skutlong missed against Amazulu as well, and those are the type of balls that you want to put in the back of the net, gain your confidence, because you do have a coach that also believes in
room, sharing stories, talking about this or that or whatever it is, and suddenly you are now elevated to a position that commands respect and a certain sense of authority that you would earn on a football pitch, and Kurt Lenke certainly has done that. Ironically, possibly is Maritzburg United will want history to repeat itself. Score plenty against this Chipper United side as Richie swings one in again. It's eyed a similar sort of scoreline today. But in fairness, I suppose anything she will do, scrape it by one goal or by five, doesn't really matter if you've got 3 points. Chipper will be hoping to hold on to that lead. Tongase, such a long throw. Richie pokes it back into the path of teammate Gwudi, who is unable
to always tell you, always stay on your feet.
Richie, the long throw here that was now to bounce. Kutlong, to go over the top, and that's gone out for the corner. Time has been added on. End of this opening half. Richie to feed. Much better looking ball here, but Roscoe Peterson has used his height nicely. Ask you, Mr. Wudise. First half, what are your insights and opinions on the opening 45?
I think with Maritzburg, there's not enough support for Hlongwane and Skelem. There's not enough penetration. There's not enough creativity with that. And I think
there's some really good throws of the ball. Changase, Richie. That's offside. Second half, they play in red, do Chipper United, as Evangar's goal separates these sides. In blue are the Maritzburg United team, the home side, looking for a goal back in this tie. They've made two changes at half time. Back towards that ball is gone out of play on the fast challenge. Sitting on a yellow card early in, and Keegan Richie arguing, saying, but the ball has gone out of play. Roscoe Peterson, Rylan Peterson, no relation. Chang Ai said, five or six passes together. It was all very disjointed. We saw that with the passing accuracy. So, Chipper United, 66% overall.
You can see with just a little bit of difference of personnel, and
I don't know sometimes.
That's a good passage of play, though. But for Evangar to realize that Skutlong is still far back to try and support you, trying to take those initiative, but also you get into those areas. At least he tried to hit the target, but that's what the confidence striker needs to do. Get inside that box. That's where you want to score goals. And because whenever you get inside the box, the defender, it's not easy for them to commit to you.
Well, he found himself looking inside from the moment he began running for the ball, wanting to see where the support was, where it might come from. Skutlong was a long way back, but he made a good 40 meters. centres up the pitch before deciding to go with a little lofted effort. Not the worst idea, and I certainly didn't miss by a great deal. Floated over the crossbar. Would have been on target had it been a little lower. There's Graham. Sitting on a yellow card coming into today's tie is Travis Graham. Amazing though when you consider how many professional footballers don't understand some of the basic laws of the game.
Yeah, but also I would say that most of the time we don't get to
the laws of the game.
Remember, I think earlier on in the season where we started seeing the linesmen getting inside the pitch, when I think it was a game in the PSL where the linesmen on the other side started getting inside the pitch because there was an offside line that
time. Getting this ball back into play. It's back in active play now with Ndenga on it. Ndengase. Keegan Ritchie. Finisher. He's trying his luck from a little way out in a slightly awkward angle as well. When confidence is high. Combination here with Gewuti approaching the hour mark. Here's Human, just possessed for the goal.
He took too much time there to decide exactly what he wanted to do when he won the ball. And I think because of Chipana that I'm pinned down defensively now, I think it's gonna be very interesting to see what Kurt Lenkis will do, because Ivanga and Sigotrong are two out and out strikers that are
the area now, beautifully set up by Hanemub. He can deliver with either foot. And maybe Maritzburg United defenders were expecting. He flicked it in with his right. And nearly. Caused a second goal.
And that's what they need right now. It was a clever play from Hanemub there on the left-hand side. That's where you want to see him going there in those areas.
Graham with the recovery. Dongwane. Graham. Only ever scored two professional goals as Travis Graham. So often he finds the courage to take a shot from range. Him on again, looking to combine. Sukuna, a man who can put on his feet. Bengu back in across the face of goal and steered away on this occasion. Ritchie driving into that 18-yard area. Graham takes it back inside of Langa, and here's Kawuti. Promising passage of play. Good maintenance of possession here by Maritzburg United.
Game positively, you want to get, you know, that equalizer, because you, now you're on top of your game. You're pinning a cheaper to defend a deeper.
Pass of Bengu. Wide, Ritchie. Tell you that Chipper United are about to bring on Sangare. There's an element of making the game tick around him, and he seems to be a player who lives for the moment when he's on the pitch. Sangare will be coming on.
Hit somebody that will carry the ball as much as Evanga will be able to hold the ball for you up front there, but you need somebody as well just to ease the pressure a little bit, help you to play, you know, force opponents to make those type of fouls.
And with plenty of movement as well, the clubs that undoubtedly brings in talent to South Africa. That's done for decades. Ritchie. Just skewing off the side of the leg of Zulu as he attempted to clear. Skellum brings it back into the path of Ritchie, who's just kept it in play. Now Sukuna might try a drive here if he can create a little space. Oh, that's going to be offside. Zulu trying to clip that ball goal bound. Sangare standing in an offside position with that delivery. Smart. Maritzburg United are not out of this game. They are controlling the possession rather better than Chipper United. Chipper United are making better use of the possession they have.
Yeah, you're right, Dwayne, because once they do have the ball, Chipper are going back to that five at the back. It becomes very, very difficult to find those spaces. But yet again, you look at still shots on target, three for Chipper, two goals, one from... One thing, Dwayne, when I had a conversation with Tata down there before...
To your point about starting to play and starting to play in a certain way, like a very valid point. It's pertinent to a few teams. But Mukhele, lovely little turn here from Mukhele, looking to tee it up and a cutback chance. There was the hat-trick on a plate for Ebanga, and he fails to hit the... Again, knocking the ball around. Jung Aze, Richie. Dengane calling the play. Graham looking to run into space to receive. Making an out. He's mentored so many of the young coaches in South Africa and around Africa as well, notably in Ghana. Delivery in here, and a ball that could have gone anywhere. That was. It's away. Dengane to Jung Aze, picked it out to Graham, Sangare chasing, Richie gets out of the challenge, only just. Skellam with a touch.
They tend to give away possession in that regard.
Side flag raised. Green here again is potentially threatening. He was... Richie to deliver. Doesn't exactly sit up, but the header is released. Perhaps a lesson as well. Richie from the set piece. Touch away. Pittsburgh United will really be wanting to find a goal here to set some consistency in the middle of the park. 3 minutes plus some added time to come, and Chipper United are defending rather stoically here. Tele. So, ball back for Richie here. That's a good looking delivery. Tlongwane has got it under control. Take 3 points. Bienvenue Ebanga. Second match in succession in which he scored a brace. Substituted off, and Tulani Mini comes on for his maiden appearance for. Jonathan Peterson gets the ball back in play very quickly here for Maritzburg United, who are desperate to find a goal in this tie. Has collected as many points as the number of points that Sundowns lead the league by currently. 17 points from Royal AM and Stellenbosch FC. Sundowns.